In this video, I'm going to show you how you can create a new Google Classroom for the upcoming school year by copying a classroom, creating a new one, and then finally how to go about adding students. If your previous Google Classrooms were organized by unit, and let's say you want to make a copy of it and reuse it, you can click the three dots of your Google Classroom and choose copy. You'll get a chance to rename it. And what it's doing, it's going to make a copy of this Google Classroom without the students and without any of the announcements, but it will preserve your topic structure as well as all of your assignments. And depending on the size of your Google Classroom, the number of assignments, it can take a while for it to make the copy. So now if I open this and go to my classroom, notice it has maintained my assignments as well as my topic organization and has put them in draft form. So when I'm ready to assign that ELA assignment one, I could just open it up, make any modifications that I need to, and then send it out to students. But right now, I don't have any students in my classroom. So there's a couple ways that you can add students. You can do it by the code where kids just visit classroom.google.com. They're going to click the plus and join class, and then they have to enter this code. Easy enough, but I do think there is another way that is easier and is going to save student time, instructional time, and if you're in a distance learning situation, it's going to eliminate a lot of frustration over what the code is and what class. So what I recommend doing is if you go to the People tab and click the People Plus, you can cut and paste student emails into this. Now, most student information systems, there's a way, once you have your roster, to download all the student email addresses. If you download that into a CSV, Excel file, whatever the choices are, you can copy and paste that into here. This is a fake class, so I don't actually have that, so I'm just going to type in the student names and click invite. Now what's going to happen on the student side is they've been invited to this class, and the next time they visit Google Classroom, I'm going to refresh, they're going to see a tile here with just a join button. And all they have to do is click this blue join button, and now they are part of that Google Classroom. I'm going to go ahead and invite another student here. And notice here in my People tab, because student one has accepted my invitation, I can tell that they are in the class. Student two is still invited. So once student two goes to their classroom.google.com, they'll see that tile. And so you have a good sense of how many students have joined your class. So right now, in this fall 2020, I only have one student in my class, even though I've invited two. Theoretically, you could even start this before the beginning of the school year. And if your students are not joining you physically in your building, you can keep track of who has accessed your Google Classroom and has been able to join, and then you can target those students and families who may need some additional support. And rather than fumbling with some kind of code, if you, from that People tab, putting in the student emails, then they'll have a classroom tile on their dashboard ready to join. If you found this video helpful, be sure to like and subscribe for future videos. Until next time, bye everyone.